You didn't tell us how to prevent invalid clicks. So this is one of the most asked questions after how much should be my budget or how do I stop or prevent invalid clicks or fraudulent clicks. You can't stop it. You can minimize for sure. You can never stop it. Just like people will steal from the shops, no matter how many security cameras they put in, how many alarms, how many security people you put in, people will find a way to steal. People will find a way to steal from banks and rob a bank. And same with Google ads or any kind of ads, there will always be some kind of fraudulent or invalid activity going on. The thing is, you need to minimize your those clicks. Now, Google ads have got a very sophisticated system to see and verify that these are invalid clicks, and you will get the credit for it. But if you want to add another layer of security on your account, then you go to some third-party apps, and there are loads of them out there. Try it. Most of them give you a free trial. I'm not going to recommend one to the other, but you try it yourself, see which one you like. Free trial is completely free trial. It's not going to cost you any money. And then see if that app has made any difference or not. So from 1st September, the ads have got disapproved because of destination mismatch. And all the ads are being disapproved. So there's something wrong what the URL you put in the ads and where you are sending it. It has got to be the same. So make sure that this is a simple mistake which can be made very easily. Just check all the ads in your account. And one of the easiest and quickest way to do that is in Google Ads Editor. You can select 10, 100, or 1,000 ads, or as many as you've got in one go. You can just check that the UR final URL is correct, and then you shouldn't have any problems. If you have checked it and you know that everything is 100%, then you need to give Google a shout and get them to check it manually. How could you use three match type for the same keyword? You can quite easily. Not a problem. All you would do is so let's say the keyword is by running shoes. So that's my exact match. That's my phrase. That's broad. So broad, it has got nothing before or after. This one is phrase with the quotation marks before and at the end. And this one is exact with the square brackets around it. So that's how you would use it. There are a couple of ways you can do that. You can either put all three in the same ad group and run it, or you can have individual ones and run it and see which one is giving the best. Now the algorithm getting better and better and more powerful, we find that when we are using max conversions or target CPA or TROAS bidding strategies, the broad seems to be working a lot. Initially, you will find that Google is going to go here, there, and everywhere, run ads or show ads for irrelevant search terms. You be very aggressive. Keep adding negative keywords. Once you've added a few hundred or a few thousand negative keywords in the account, the broad match is going to work wonderfully well. I never thought I would say that because we never used to use broad match before. And it's going to give the cheapest click as well. And it's going to show you and give you search terms which you never considered. And secondly, Exact match is not exact anymore. Phrase match is not phrase anymore, because Google is going to show ads for close variants of phrase as well as exact. So why make more work for yourselves? You know, try that. All right, I'm a beginner, launching my first ever product and don't know where to begin. All right, where to begin? It's a very broad question. It all depends what the goals of your campaigns are. If you want lead generation or sales, I would start with search campaign. If you want branding as well as a bit of lead generation and sales, then you need to have certain budgets for top of the funnel, as middle of the funnel and bottom of the funnel, on YouTube and display network. If you are a beginner, I would not recommend you go everywhere first, i.e. search, display, and YouTube. Just do one. Get it right properly. So start with search, because that's going to give you the best bang for your buck. Having said that, YouTube also works wonderfully well for us, and display network. So you just pick one network and get good at it. Why did you choose to be an ads guy rather than an SEO guy? Okay. Interesting question. Now, with SEO, you need to have a lot of patience. You need to have, you need to invest a lot of time, energy, resources, and money as well. And I'm not scared of investing time, money, or resources. You cannot be on Google page one tomorrow. Dependent on your niche, dependent on the level of competition you have. If your competitors are noobs and they don't know how to do digital marketing, they haven't got a clue, then putting up a few blog posts on your website and optimizing it and doing a bit of SEO is going to get you on page one fairly quickly, but still it will take you a few weeks or months. But with ads, you can be on Google page one tomorrow. And the other most important factor between SEO and ads is this. Let's say you are doing SEO. You've done your keyword research. How do you know whether those keywords are going to convert or not? So if you pick up the wrong keyword and start optimizing for those keywords, but they don't convert, what's the point of driving that traffic? But if you pick up 15, 20, 30, 50 keywords, run ads, see which one is converting the most or giving you the most ROI, you then pick up those keywords and do the SEO. So you know that you are going to win at the end of the day. With SEO, you've got a blindfold over your eyes and you wonder whether you're going to win or not, because you don't know those keywords are going to convert. So, and also I like Google Ads when I started using it. It's just amazing what it can do and it can help you achieve. And now with search, display, YouTube, Performance Max, it's just a lot of fun.